Hello students, welcome to the class on editorial decode, and in this class I will be decoding all the four editorials of the day. Now out of all the four editorials, we have two most important editorials. The first is the top corner editorial and the other is the lead editorial, and rest of the editorial, that is the bottom corner and the sub lead editorial, they are not important from examination point of view. Now, as far as the lead editorial is concerned, this is very, very important from international relations point of view. Now, this editorial relates to how the world is viewing the entire diplomatic changes that is unfolding in the world. Now, diplomatic realm mein jo changes unfold ho rahe hain, ye uske baare mein hai. Ye editorial ek analysis hai कि जो भी चेंजेस अनफोल्ड हो रहे हैं और जिस तरह प्रिंट मीडिया और इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया इन चेंजेस को रिप्रेजेंट कर रहा है, पुट फॉरवर्ड कर रहा है, उसमें कुछ लेकुनाज हैं. नो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल द प्रिंट मीडिया एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक मीडिया इज प्रोपगेटिंग अ व्यू पॉइंट, अ प्रोपेगेंडा इज बीइंग जनरेटेड दैट द ग्लोबलाइजेशन इज एंडिंग. नाउ दिस लीड एडिटोरियल्स ऑथर Hardeep Puri is countering this view. Now, according to the author, globalization is actually not melting. And the Western world is not against globalization. It is only that they are witnessing a period of lull growth, a period of low growth, a period of stagnant growth. And this is something that is causing them to worry. But in essence, the Western world is not against globalization, and it is too early to predict the death of a globalization, because in the past also we had predicted that the globalization is dying, but this is something that has not happened in the reality. Now the another thing that the author is talking about, that the world is predicting that the China is creating a web of communicational lanes. And by creating this communication lanes, it is trying to ascendize itself in the economic realm. So China kya kar raha hai? China OBOR project se, aur China apne aur communication lane project se ek web create karne ki koshish kar raha hai. Aur us web ko create karke wo apne aap ko economically ascendize kar raha hai. Dusron ke upar havi karne ki koshish kar raha hai. And the world is predicting that very soon the China will be replacing the number one world economy, that is United States of America. But this is not a realistic thing. This is not a realistic thing. Why this is not a realistic thing? First of all, China's economy is at least half that of United States of America's. And on the other hand, when you look at the sophistication of the research done in United States of America, the research done in China is no match to that. And when it comes to the economic prowess of United States of America, it is far, far ahead that of China. So it is too early to comment, it is too early to judge, it is too early to pass a verdict that the China is marching ahead of United States of America. Now, another analysis done by the author, that why China cannot march ahead of United States of America. The reason for that is China is trying to hegemonize itself over the other nations in order to implement its OBOR project. But this is something that will not be easy. Agar aapko itne projects implement karne, aapko land acquisition karna padega, aapko un deshon ke जो कमर्स पॉलिसीज है, जो उनकी इकोनॉमिक पॉलिसीज है, जो उनकी कम्युनिकेशन पॉलिसीज है, जो उनकी एग्रीकल्चर रिलेटेड पॉलिसीज है, उनको अल्टर करना पड़ेगा. एंड सिर्फ वो करके ही आप ये सारे प्रोजेक्ट्स इंप्लीमेंट कर पाओगे. एंड अगर उन देशों की आपने इन्वेस्टमेंट करानी है, अगेन दिस इज नॉट ईजी, बिकॉज मोस्ट ऑफ द कंट्रीज थ्रू विच दीज कम्युनिकेशन लेन्स विल बी पासिंग, दोज कंट्रीज आर ऑलरेडी अंडर इकोनॉमिक स्ट्रेस एंड डिस्ट्रेस, और काफी ज्यादा अभी तनाव है आर्थिक स्थिति को लेके इन देशों में, जहां जहां से ये ओबी और ओआर निकलेगा. सो ये इजी नहीं रहे इन देशों के लिए कि वो चाइना का जो इकोनॉमिक मॉडल है वो इंप्लीमेंट कर पाए. सो दीज आर सम ऑफ द सब्सटेंटिव रीजंस व्हाई China will not be able to forge ahead of United States of America. So this is all about the lead editorial. This is very, very important from examination point of view. अगर mains में question आता है critically analyze OBOR, तो उसमें ये काफी points हैं जो आप use कर सकते हो answer लिखने के लिए mains में एक अच्छा answer. Now you have the top corner editorial. This relates to prevention of cruelty to animals act. Now recently government has come out with the rules and regulations that they will be prohibiting the cutting of cows, the cutting of the cattle and transporting them in a manner which inflicts pain and injury to them. Now such kind of acts by the government, they are not in consonance with the spirit of the constitution. Because by doing all this, by passing such rules and regulations, they are actually differentiating between different type of animals. So this is like inflicting biasness. This is like inflicting the prejudice of one religion over the other. So now onwards, the butchering of the cattle will not be allowed in India. But this is something that will be contested in the court. On the basis of secularism, on the basis of right to life, and on the basis of choice that the people have in India to have any type of meal that they want to. So the rules and the regulations in the future might not be able to hold against the test of the judiciary. So this was all for the editorial. You can subscribe to this channel. Name of the channel is BrainyIAS. You can contact me at 845-940-0000 in case you're interested in buying the video classes or entire civil services preparation. So this was all for the day. Bye bye. Take care. Have a nice day.